My name is Priya. I'm a second year PhD student. Our lab's main focus is neurodegenerative disorders, but Alzheimer's is like our model because we need to take an example to explain all the neurodegenerative disorders. So we are trying to identify what causes it and in what ways we can treat it or manage it. So I'm basically from India. So I did all my previous education over there until I moved here to pursue my PhD. My parents are not scientists. So my dad is into finance and my mom is into law. So they're completely different from anywhere close to science. I was always interested in biology. It always excited me, the urges to know how animals, plants adapt to changing environment fascinated me. So initially I got into research just by chance. So I did my master's in human genetics where we had to do 6 months research work, and it so happened that I got into neurodegenerative disorder research where I concentrated mainly on Parkinson's disease. And coincidentally, it so happened that at the same time, my grandfather, my dad's dad, was diagnosed with Parkinson's-like symptoms, unfortunately due to which he passed away. So I think that further motivated me to get into research, focused mainly on neurodegenerative disorders. And that's how I'm here. So my short-term goal is to get something beneficial to the society towards the neurodegenerative disorders, and to get something useful for the cure or treatment or even management of neurodegenerative disorders. We mainly work on flies, that is Drosophila, which are the fruit flies which you find on all the ripened fruits. And it's really interesting that their genetic makeup is very similar to ours. So that's our main model organism. And then we use tools such as pipettes and petri dish, the small dishes on which we do dissections. Life in the lab is really exciting, especially initially when you come in. There are a lot of people, such as other graduate students. There are a lot of undergrads whom we interact with, and lab technicians. So it's very social, in fact. It's not a very lonely life. But I guess as you get towards your, more towards your research, you are more focused, and then you get to interact lesser, I guess, with undergraduates. But on the whole, I think it's not lonely. It's like it involves a lot of interactions. We have a lot of social events where we get together and talk science as well as other stuff. Hopefully my research turns out to be amazing and I get to have my own lab one day where I would have students working under me. Hopefully I'm able to mentor them and get something really good for the society. So if you're interested in science, if you like to learn or discover different things, if you like to do experiments, which you would have done in your high school, and learn about organisms, teach about organisms, write about organisms, then I think this is the right place for you. You should get into research or a lab.